York and jazz, one word often associated with the other in the music industry. Originating in the US in the early 20th century, jazz has early influences and roots from African and European music. Many of jazz's most memorable legends originated from the cities New Orleans, Chicago, and New York City.
We have a completely different experience, which is our Harlem, our Soulful Sunday in Harlem jazz tour, where we go and give people sort of a panoramic view of the African-American experience in jazz in New York. We start out at an American Legion Hall, which is a private club where you need to sign in to come in with wonderful soul food cooked there and drinks, and it's a very local experience.
Among Indonesian musicians who are recognized in New York is Joey Alexander, the young pianist from Bali, Indonesia, who has already released two albums, My Favorite Things and Countdown, while Indonesian artists Bujana and Topati launched their progressive jazz albums with Moon June Records.
You know, I think, you know, people always say, you know, jazz is so hard to understand, but I think if you hear people like Louis Armstrong, you feel that joy, and you can still dance with it. So I wanna have people really enjoy my music. That's for me.
There are artists from New York and New Jersey that are well known in Indonesia, especially Jakarta. They include Gordon Campbell, Dionne Warwick, Michelle Walker, and drummer Harvey Macy, all of whom performed at the Java Jazz Festival held in Jakarta, Indonesia. Harvey also performed the collaboration with jazz vocalist Dira Sugandi.
I love Java Jazz Festival. I've known Peter Gonthe for a very, very long time. And I remember when this was just a dream and he wanted to have a festival. And we'd come over and play, and he would go to his house and hang and play with his house. Then he had jams. Then he said, I'm starting the festival, and I want it to be the largest. And at one point, it was probably the largest festival in the world over the years.
Tahun kemarin itu, saya sebenarnya tadinya ingin dipasangkan juga dengan Harvey Mason karena vokalisnya cedera, tapi saya diminta untuk menggantikan mendadak, tapi sayangnya tahun kemarin saya nggak bisa. Tapi Harvey itu sudah excited gitu. Di mana nih Dira katanya mau nyanyi sama saya gitu kan. Mungkin dia udah denger-denger, saya nggak ngerti juga. Rasanya, karena saya tahu ya dia kan orang musisi legend dari Amerika gitu, jadi nervous banget gitu. Tapi ternyata pas latihan juga, daripada waktu pada saat kita latihan itu, dia udah memberikan kepercayaan gitu ya sama saya, bahwa dia bilang kamu pasti okay, gitu. Jadi ya,
for New Yorkers, Java Jazz Festival is considered a barometer of jazz music, not only in Indonesia but all of Asia.
I think that every artist in every culture has a place here in New York City. This American-born music really has become the world's music. It is the one unique unifier around the world.
Setiap tahun tuh emang apa acaranya tuh menarik banget. Maksudnya kayak musisi yang ditampilkan, baik itu Indonesia dan internasional, benar-benar menarik ya. Maksudnya kayak emang tahun ini emang temanya jazz, celebrate jazz in diversity. Jadi emang benar-benar dari musik blues, dari ragtime, swing, big band, sampai fusion, eksperimental, sampai R&B soul. Istilahnya jazz itu emang musik yang benar-benar bisa apa ya, bisa berevolusi dengan musik sekarang. Jadi emang kita bisa ngeliat di Java Jazz tahun ini, jadi benar-benar beragam dari 3 hari ini. Penampilan yang dari musisi-musisinya sangat menarik menurut saya.
New York City is often regarded as one of the pillars and barometers of American jazz music. Tourists and jazz enthusiasts come from all over the world to visit New York because they want to know how jazz in New York has influenced and become a part of the lifestyle in society.
What we're doing is we're basically taking you in a time machine for a night on two very different experiences. One in the 20s and 30s, where swing music and dancing was all the rage, and the other one a real embodiment of the African-American experience in the 50s and 60s. It doesn't matter what culture you're from. As long as you like jazz and you play jazz, this world is so multicultural, you know? It's the world's music now. It's not just American music, it's the world's music.
Narottama, then Oliver Cross, VOA, New York.